Hello everyone, my name is Noah James Gonzalez. Friends and families call me Nonong Gonzalez, a name given to me by my grandpa which I like, and a name which established my identity. I invite you, together with my mom Angelia, grandma Nancy, Tita Gian, and my grandpa Jimmy, to come travel with me as I journey around the world to see the beautiful places, its people and culture, and taste its native delicacies. Bat City, Unitary Authority of Bat in Northeast Somerset, Historic County of Somerset, southwestern England. Bat lies astride the River Avon, Lower or Bristol Avon, in a natural arena of stiff hills. It was built of local limestone and is one of the most elegant and architecturally distinguished of British cities. Its 16th century abbey church of St. Peter and St. Paul is late Perpendicular Gothic and is noted for its windows. But it is the wealth of classical Georgian buildings mounting the steep valley sides that gives Bath its distinction. The city was designated a UNESCO World Heritage Site in 1987. The hot mineral springs on the site attracted the Romans, who founded Bath as Aquae Sulis, dedicated to the goddess Sulis Minerva, an amalgamation of Celtic and Roman deities. The Saxons built an abbey on the site wherein 973 CE Edgar was crowned the first king of all England. The Normans subsequently rebuilt the church between 1088 and 1122, transferring this the diocese they had founded at Wales. The bishop's throne returned to Wales in 1206, and there was a long rivalry between the canons of Wales and the monks of Bath, of which the bishop was titular abbot. The diocese is still styled Bats and Wills. Medieval Bath, incorporated by charter in 1189, shared in the west of England wool trade, and later in the cloth trade. But the baths, although still used by royalty, were poorly maintained. When portions of the Roman baths were rediscovered in 1755, Bath had already revived as a spa. In its heyday as a fashionable resort, precedent over by the social figure Richard Nash, one of the greatest England dandies, the Elizabethan town was rebuilt and extended in Palladian style by the architects John Wood, the Elder and the Younger, and their patron, Ralph Allen, who provided the stone from his local quarries and built the mansion of Prior Park in 1735-48, overlooking the city. In 1769-74, Robert Adam built Pulteney's Bridge to connect Bath with the new suburb of Bathwick across the River Avon. Close to the abbey in the entrenched valley of the River Avon is the 18th century pump room, giving access to the hot springs and Roman baths. Among some 140 historic terraces and individual buildings that grace the city are Queen Square, built by John Wall the Elder between 1728 and 1735. The Circus, begun by Wood in 1754, and completed by his son, the Royal Crescent, 1767-75, likewise designed by the father and completed by the son. The Guide Hall, 1775, Limestone Crescent, built by John Palmer, 1796 to 97, and the 1795 Pavilion in Sydney Gardens, Batwick, which now houses the art collection of the Holborn Museum. In 1942, the assembly rooms of 1771 were destroyed in the air raid, from which the whole city suffered severely. But extensive reconstruction, as well as renovation, has since been carried out. The assembly rooms reopened in 1963, now contain the Fashion Museum, a world-class collection of fashionable dress from the 17th to the 21st century. Clapperton Manor, 2 miles outside the city, is an early 19th century mansion housing the American Museum in Britain, a large museum of Americana. As the leading center of English high society outside London in the 18th century and early 19th centuries, the city is rich in literary associations. The life of the time is graphically depicted in the novels of Tobias Smollett and in the plays of Richard Brinsley Sheridan. Jane Austen's novel Northanger Abbey and Persuasion, bought in 1817, portrayed with delicate satire in keen perception the fashionable life of Bath about 1800. Bath Oliver's the biscuit that take their name from William Oliver, an eminent physician who founded what is now the Royal National Hospital for rheumatic diseases, bath buns, bath breaks, and bath chairs for the invalid, all derived their names from this city. As I pause here, I hope you enjoy our ride. Don't forget to watch my next episode, and please hit the red subscribe button below, for it means so much for me. Until next time, thank you so much.